Good morning, my dear students. So hope you are all fine. How was Yugadi celebration? So we are stepping into a new year from today. So hope it's going to bring in a lot of joy and peace of mind for all of you. Right. So today we are going to discuss again about controls in Visual Basic. So this class is especially it's going to be the continuation of the previous class. In the previous class, theoretically, we have discussed what are the controls in Visual Basic. So today we are going to just extend that and see some examples. So this class actually comes from the feedback I have received from the students. Some students felt that they would like to also see the IDE and also experience how it works. So yeah, I have picked up an example which is going to have all the controls, most of the controls, and we are going to discuss those controls. So whatever examples we have discussed, whatever properties we have discussed earlier, we are going to make sure that we are going to see that in practicals also in the VB IDE. So hope you will enjoy the class. Right, so let us start with the first thing. First and foremost thing is a form. So first and foremost tool which you should be aware of in your Visual Basic IDE is going to be a form. Form, we have actually discussed most of it. Load, we have discussed. Hide, we have discussed. So one thing I have picked up for today, which I think most of you have not experienced it in the lab, is the Windows state. Okay, so I will have to jump between the PPT and the IDE. So we will do that. So now this is the example I have chosen. So first thing I promised you is to tell you what is a Windows state. So Windows state is a form property. So first property here is going to be the form property, right? So I will show you what is that Windows state property. So I've clicked on the form now. So what I'm seeing here scrolling down is a form property. I'm going to choose the Windows property as maximized. Windows state property, I'm going to choose it as maximized. Let's say by default it is going to be normal. Now I've made it into maximized. Let us see what happens. So I'm executing. You can see it comes in a maximized mode where you can see the whole form stretched to the screen of my laptop. So you can see that this is the maximized property. Yes, of the Windows state. So the property here is the Windows state property. It is maximized. Next, we'll see what is a normal. Okay, normal, how it looks. So when you see maximized only, you will know how the normal, what is the difference between maximum and normal. So now I'm going to show you how the normal is going to look like. Can you see? This is going to be the normal. Then in the during the design, whatever was the size of your form, the size is going to remain the same even afterwards, after you execute. So that is nothing but your normal screen size, right? There is also a minimum screen size. So minimized, which means you won't be able to see the form. So it is going to be minimized. It is going to look minimized. Say here, I'm executing, but only the coding is seen. The form design, I'm not able to see. I will try to see it from here. Here also, it comes as only when I click on that, I'm able to see. So what happened? It was minimized. So I had to click and bring it back. Okay, so this is going to be the minimized mode, which is the one of the Windows state mode, right? Yes, so I've discussed the Windows state mode, and then as you move on, you have text boxes and so many other things. Before all that, I would like to tell you what program I have chosen and how does it execute. So what is the actual design? How does the design actually fits? What is the requirement of this coding? So let me explain that to you. So here I have the program here. See, the program is like this. You are going to select a course. If, for example, you are going to take a visual programming course. So you are going to select that course. So you have to fill in this application form. So what are the elements in that particular application form? So there is your name. So there is going to be a current date. So your today's date. So or whenever you are applying. And then there is department. Okay, so there are three departments I have chosen. BCA, BBA and BCom. And there is semester. So semester is going to have 1 to 6 semesters. Subjects are going to be for that particular semester. What are the subjects that will be listed? You can choose the particular course. So that is the main intention. Okay. So why have I chosen all these components is, I wanted to explain first thing is list box. Then I have to explain the combo box, right? These two are the combo boxes. Okay. So that's why I picked up this. Again, I want to explain how this option button is used. I wanted to explain also how this checkbox is used. So this is why I have picked this particular program. So as I execute, you will come to know what are the different elements which we have discussed in the previous class. How are we implementing all of them here, right? Yes. So let me execute first so that you will see how the program works, and then I can explain one by one to you, right? So I think still it is in the minimized mode. So let me go and change. What property should I be changing now? Yes. Yeah, I heard you. So you'll be changing the window state property. I will keep it as normal, right? And then start executing. I'm saving it. Right, I'm going to execute it. Right, here, so let me see how the program is going to work. First, I'm going to enter a name. Yes, then I'm going to choose a date. So obviously I want to apply today, right? So this is going to be a date and time picker. This is something which we have seen. So I told you date and time picker, you can either choose date or time. So I have chosen date picker where there is a calendar visible. Then I have chosen one date from there. I'm able to choose a date from there instead of typing it all by myself. Then there is a list box here. I'm going to select the course. This particular course BCA, BBA and BCom, I'm going to select it from a list box. This box is like this. It doesn't have any drop down buttons here. You will be able to see everything. So it will occupy a lot of space because whatever items are there, all the items will be visible at once. That is going to be your list box. Then comes your combo box where you're going to have one text box plus one drop down together. So here I've chosen BCA. I wanted to choose a semester here. So I've chosen BCA as the course. I've chosen second semester. As soon as I say second semester, you'll be able to see the subjects in the second semester. You'll be able to see all the subjects in the second semester. This is again one more combo box. So why these three combo boxes? We will see, right? Now that you should understand is the purpose of these three boxes is first is to choose whether it is BBA, BCom or BCA. Second one is going to choose which semester class you wanted to take up. Third one is going to choose which subject class you wanted to take up. So you want to register or apply for a particular course. Right. Then comes the application number. Here I have again used another property of a text box, which is going to be maximum length, which means I have said maximum length is 5. I won't be able to enter any value more than 5. So it is giving me that the bell rings. So you will know that it is limiting. So it is the maximum length property which does this, right? So as you know, this is the option button. Only one you can choose from a group. This is a checkbox. You can choose more than one from a group. So I have used checkbox here for choosing the value added program. With this program, you want any other value added program, then you have to choose programs from here. So then I'm going to also ask you for username. So I'm going to have a username and password. This password I'm using just for the for you to know what you mean by the pass character property. So what do you mean by pass character property? So whenever I enter a text in this particular text box, it's not like the previous text box, this one. Whenever I enter some text in this text box, the text actually comes there. Whatever I entered, you'll be able to see in the text box. But here password should not, that should not happen with password. So though I'm going to enter the same text, you will not be able to see. You are only able to see asterisks here. So this is done using a property called as password char. It's a very important property. So that's, I want to explain that. That's why I have introduced this particular password in this form, right? So I have entered the values. Now I will be submitting. As soon as I submit, I'm getting a text box here, which has multiple line values. So this property or multi-line property of a text box can be witnessed here. Adding a scroll bar to that, text box can be seen here. So it also has vertical and horizontal scroll bar. You have also seen that. So the whole purpose of this program is to explain you all these elements and components, right? So we have first completed form, because form I wanted to tell you in the beginning. Once you execute, you will know what is the form window state property. So other properties we have seen. Most of the properties we have already seen. Load form, show form, hide form, all these things we have already used in format program and so on. So only thing I wanted to actually show you is this window state property of a form. Now we will start one by one. We will keep the list box, combo box to the end. So let me finish the other things because that has to be explained in detail, right? Yes. First thing, let us start with the date and time picker. This also is going to be a very, very important 2-mark or a 5-mark question. What do you mean by a date and time picker? First thing you should say about date and time picker is that it is used to either pick, select a date or select a time. So there are two things you can select. You can select date and you can also select time. How are we going to do it? We have to go to project components. So what did we see about the date and time picker? So we have to go to Microsoft Windows Common Control 2.6.0. So that is what we are going to do now, right? So we are going to go here, project components, right? Microsoft Windows Common Control 2.6.0. Can you see that ticked? As soon as I tick that, so what you get is all these components belongs to that particular, yes, ActiveX control. So all this belongs to that particular ActiveX control, of which I'm going to choose the date and time picker. I've chosen date and time picker and I have drawn it here. So it is nothing but your date time picker, right? So you already saw the calendar mode where you saw the date, you picked the date. So now I will change the property and show you how do you pick a time. So I'm going to say it's going to be short date. I'm going to have it as time and execute, say. So when you see time, it is going to be you have to enter hour, minutes and seconds, right? So this is what happens. So this is what you should be doing. You have to enter hour, minute and second. This is going to be the time property of it. So this date and time picker can be used for two purposes, either if you want a date or whatever format of date, long date, short date or custom date, you can have it. So, or you have to have a time. So you can have it in time. So in previously I have used short date. So long date will have everything 26th March 2020. Short date is going to have something like this 26/03/2020. So this is the use of date and time picker. Some properties also we have seen about date and time picker. Say for example, the minimum and maximum date. So I can say the applicants should be of a particular age or cannot apply before a particular date. So I want them either to apply it today or apply it anytime in the future. Say I will say that the last date is 30th. So after 30th, I will not allow them to do that, to apply. So I will give that. Minimum date will be, say, starting from 20th, we are receiving application forms. So that will be the minimum date. After 30th, you should not be applying, you won't be able to apply. Then I will set the maximum date as 30. So this is how the minimum date and maximum date happens, applies, right? So first we saw form, the window state property. Next we have seen date and time picker. So we have seen what are the various modes in date and time picker. We have also seen minimum date, maximum date properties and values of date and time picker. Hope you understand. Right, we will move on. Next one is going to be your option button. So in option button, you have already seen. So there is value property. Value will be true, can be true and can be false. So when will value property be true? Whenever I click on this, whenever you see a dot here, the value property is true. Whenever you see is blank, the value property is false. So that we have done in the vending machine program actually. So that is the work of the option button. Option button, there is another thing also you should remember. I can only choose one. Okay, I cannot choose more than one value here. It can either be part-time or full-time. So situations wherein you can only click one, choose one, you have to use a use a option button. So wherein you have to choose multiple values, then you are going to use checkboxes. So checkboxes can have multiple options. So what I can do is more than one option I will be allowed to choose. So that is situations we are going to use what? Checkboxes, right? The next thing is, so checkboxes and option button over. So only these things are there which you should know about checkboxes and option buttons, right? The other thing is, as I told you, so username is a normal text box, not